would win this tournament besides themselves, and everyone said Superlek is the favorite.
That was a beautiful hand combination landed by Walter Gonsalves right there, but Superlek immediately starts throwing those legs.
Walter's gonna have the speed. Superlek, no doubt, the power in the hands. Volume-wise, it'll go the way of Gonsalves. Let's see if Walter can execute his game plan and a nice low leg kick from the Brazilian early on here.
Walter was extremely confident going into this match all week, telling me exactly how he was gonna get it done, and he really wants to go in and out and utilize all of his different weapons. Look at him changing stances. And Superlek's having a hard time getting a read on this movement. Look how aggressive Walter's coming out.
And it's the same problem Rod Zhang had when they fought over in Tokyo. He couldn't read the movement, the little pirouettes, the quarter angle turns, the sheer speed of getting in and out of Walter Gonsalves.
Yeah, I love the way he changes stances too. The way he comes forward, it's almost reminiscent of really what DJ does in a lot of his stance changes.
Catch and counter, perfectly legal under these Muay Thai rules. Once again, folks, this is striking in 4-ounce gloves. You used to see Muay Thai boxing. Oh, come on! Stuck him in the left, no knockdown, says the referee. And now a chance for Superlek. He stunned Gonsalves with that one, Dragon.
Yeah, it looked like he fell backwards, but he popped right back up and his ball got
again.
No question on that one. I thought the first one was a knockdown as well. He may not be getting up, and he's cut.
This could be over!
No, no,
this could
not
be over!
Williams looking to shock the world here tonight. Outside low kick, snapping it through, and then a push kick from Superlek. Nice straight right from Williams to open.
Yeah, it's gonna be the hands of Williams against the kicking game of Superlek.
Yeah, if I was Williams in this match, I would be very selective with the kicks that I throw, because he does not recover from his kicks with his balance as quickly as Superlek does.
Superlek in the red gloves, Williams in the blue.
DDT showcasing good movement early on here as he's smart, right? He's circling to Superlek's somewhat weaker side. I don't even know if you can call any sides of Superlek weak, but he's circling to the non-dominant side and moving to his right away from that power kick of Superlek, which is extremely important.
Push kick from Superlek. See a little bit in the outside leg kick and another push from Superlek. Under two in round one. Swinging wildly to the left, coming up empty as Mini T.
Superlek's maintaining that range with push kick. Getting difficult for Mini T to get to the inside here. Wondering if that, what I was talking about before the match, creating that desperation, those desperation moves that he needs to do to close the distance.
Big motions coming from Superlek.
Nice move from Williams.
Superlek's got Williams is got a question about that one more catch from late too. Keep in mind, he was actually preparing for a Muay Thai match, so he's got to disrupt that natural instinct of catching the leg here in kickboxing.
High kick from Williams.
Yeah, Mini T is a WMC Muay Thai World Champion. He's fought primarily in Muay Thai. So this call up to the big league in kickboxing is a gigantic step up. So he's gonna be fighting a lot of his natural tendencies to catch, to elbow. He's gonna have to eliminate two of his favorite weapons and focus on just the six limbs.
Oh, low kick there in the groin from Superlek.
I think one of the problems they're going to have to solve in Daniel Williams' corner when he goes back here, similarly to what we just saw with Rodriguez and Jan Todd, is that Superlek is the one that's moving forward and going to be seen as the aggressor as this match continues.
Love the leg kicks coming from Superlek early on, because that is going to stop that movement, or at least slow down the movement of Mini T, who's getting on his bicycle and continually moving to that non-dominant side, I'll call it. Can't call anything a Superlek's weak, but he's starting to touch that leg up.
Yeah, you can see the outside of Daniel Williams' left leg there on the thigh. It's starting to look like hamburger already in the first round.
Round two. come right out with a 1-2 mini T. That kick from Superlek. Body kick from mini T.
Ozzy's in the crowd here, yeah, showing love to their Australian compatriot. Mini T having a hard time touching the legs of Superlek, and Superlek goes head hunting, but Mini T showcasing his reflexes, ducking out of the way.
He's been pretty elusive so far, Williams.
The best spot that Superlek's had, the best target has been that leg. You can just see the lead leg of Mini T is not going to be feeling well in that long flight back to Australia tomorrow.
It's not just the leg. Look at the entire left side of the ribcage of Williams' body. It's all red as well. That was a perfect example of that kick that Williams just threw there. He missed that kick, took him time to actually get back on balance, and Superlek right away threw a counter kick.
Head kick from Superlek. Williams trying to respond. Again, 2021, he fought Rotte. Williams did. It was the fight of the year. So he always puts on exciting fights, win or lose, when you're talking about Mini T.
Superlek going up top. Good defense from Mini T.
Kick from Superlek.
Yeah, I heard that one. I felt that one from the commentary booth.
Yeah, it's like paintball war, just leaving marks every single time. Mini T's on the onslaught, works his way out of it. Superlek looking for the finish here in two.
Superlek bringing with a chin and a body kick. Push kick Superlek, minute to go. Round two, walking down Mini T right now.
The work that Superlek has done in the first round and, you know, this round now with the legs has got Mini T kind of misreading things and now starting to open up Superlek's, his hand combinations. His jab is starting to become more active. He's landing several of them.
Right, the ribcage, entire body there in the front for Williams, showing a lot of tenderness after all these body kicks from Superlek in the opening two rounds.
Yeah, there was a lot to be said about Superlek's offense and his impressive kicking game and knees, but it's also almost impossible to catch Superlek, to hit him cleanly. He absorbs less significant shots than almost any fighter in one Super Series. He's like trying to nail jelly to a tree. It's just impossible to get.
Mini T, he'll angle off, and he might make Superlek miss, but Superlek is quick to recover from a missed strike, whether it's a kick or a punch. In the moment that Mini T angles off, Superlek's already throwing another combination. Like, he just doesn't give, he doesn't give Danny Williams time to actually reset. Look at him start to pepper his jab.
Man, the way he follows that knee up with those kicks. He's a thing of beauty. He'll hurt you to the body with the knees, and then as your hand starts to come down, he'll come up top with the head kick.
Midway point in the fight. We are in the third. Steps in with that one to create more damage.
So Daniel there stepped in for that right cross in to the body, but he's reaching.
Up your hands, Daniel.
See that backward movement? That's the point I'm talking about from Superlek right there. Just mitigated with a little backward movement. Mini T threw the kick, completely missed. And then Superlek followed up with two kicks, and there was the step in knee again.
If Mini T, as this fight goes on, needs one shot to win, does he have that knockout power against a guy like Superlek?
He does. You know, he has the power in that right hand. Just, I mean, so accurate with it, comes straight down the middle. But again, this is a bigger weight. This is a flyweight. He's used to starching people at straw weight. And that power might not carry up over somebody that is hooked down.
Boxing as well, Mitch. This is going to be a very interesting matchup.
So black and white, Nabil. In the black and purple, and immediately.
Superlek goes after Nabil's gigantic legs and then touches gloves.
Great defense so far, though, for Nabil to pull away from the low kick.
Nabil does have incredibly fast reaction time and a super long reach. Checked early on by Superlek, and he's going to need those.
7-5 win streak for Nabil. Two-time WBC world champion. No doubt the biggest test so far though of his career against the two-time one flyweight kickboxing champ, Superlek.
Going to the legs early. The kicking machine looks to chop down the long limbs of Nabil. Nabil doing a good job of evading that right leg and answering back.
Jabbed as well, Mitch. Superlek trying to fuck the hand.
Elbow landed by Nabil.
Yeah, Superlek's got to watch out. Can I get overconfident? Because Nabil has those long elbows that can do a lot of damage on Superlek.
Superlek said that the only weapon Nabil has is his length. He has no power. He has no speed. I'll be able to counter him in every single instance. But right now, Nabil is proving him wrong, reacting very fast and moving very well in the early stages of this round.
Ooh, that one. That one hurt him, Mitch, the leg kick.
Yeah, that one bothered Nabil. And he crashes to the ground in the very first round.
Watch that right kick of Superlek. He goes to the body with it about 49% of the time. Loves to punish the body and just slowly break down his opponents. I like that because Taiki Naito has really good eyes. He's able to evade and counter. Superlek marching forward, feinting the right kick. Ooh, went to the body with the push kick. That was nice.
Everything off the right side so far for Superlek Kepmukar. High kick, tries to thread it over the top of the left shoulder. Nice tip to the midsection from Superlek.
Look at that, good eyes. I mean, he's mixing up his weapons really well. Teep into the body, teep into the legs. Oh, nice little sweep right there.
Mitch is coming to the head a lot more with that round kick than I expected in the opening round.
Yeah, he usually starts going to the body. I mean, that's his favorite shot. He breaks down the arms, but I think he wants a finish.
He
wants to make it quick work.
What he predicted, what did I say? Head kick or elbow, and already that's what he's doing. That head kicks and he tried to bring the elbows into play.
He's setting it up. I like the way he's going up the middle, though, with the push kick, too.
I'm going to say, though, Naito looks unfazed so far, remaining relaxed on the outside.
Ooh, you hear that? It's a mean leg kick.
Naito, once again, that crazy game plan he had in that eight-week camp to take Superlek's body kicks and counter off them.
You can hear the corner of Naito saying, be careful, take your time.
Superlek wants to finish this early. There's no time for Superlek. He wants him out of here in the first.
Yeah, he wants to get him out of there, but Naito's doing a good job of defending. You know, he's not really been fazed by a lot of these shots. He needs to put together some combinations, though. Get some of this pressure off of him.
And stamp a little authority of his own.
He needs to earn that respect of Superlek, because right now Superlek is kind of picking and jiving right now. Nice little leg kick though. Look at that, the way he's chopping at those legs. See what I was saying about the leg kicks? That's what Naito does well, is he chops at your legs, especially disrupting your balance and your rhythm.
The defense is good so far for Taiki Naito, but defense will not win you the fight.
That's what he's doing. He's trying to counter these kicks that are coming from Superlek, but he's beating him to the punch. He's not trying to take it. I think he was just having fun with us.
Here's a nice forearm guard to leg kick from Naito. Thought about a front kick. Resets himself. Big outside leg kick, top of the thigh there from Superlek, rolls the right hand over.
Nice job though. I know Superlek landed that right, but it was a nice little move from Naito to come underneath it and throw that left hook. On the walk when he was running around the circle of the introductions, he gave me a little look like he knew something that we might not know, and it's showing here. He's doing a good job against Superlek.
On the outside, he's
he might want to give it to Superlek.
Second round set for three.
Taiki Naito, see again, he's immediately starting to go after that leg. He's trying to counter, but those he's taken. So you can see how a little bit more aggressive Superlek is coming out after that illegal shot.
There's the body kick from Superlek off the right leg, the one he's renowned for.
Yeah, I like the idea of Superlek going to the leg. You can already see the reddening start to develop on Naito. Ooh, that was mean.
That right leg is starting to power up now. Inside leg, Naito goes outside leg. Tries to counter up the round kick, Naito, he's fast. Gets locked in the clinch here, back Superlek against the fence.
Naito landed a high kick right there that caught the chin of Superlek.
Running back in, running back.
So watch the knees of that kidney area.
Naito is not being outclassed here by the tournament favorite. I'd like to see him set up that low kick a little bit.
I like that little spinning back elbow he tried to land there, Superlek. That was sweet. Nice low check from the Thai. Good inside leg kick from Naito. Catch and counter from the Japanese.
Nice push kick. He's landing that push kick right up the middle.
Naito on the outside as he was for much of the first round.
Not a lot of movement though coming from Naito. He chooses to just keep his back there against the wall and rely on his eyes for defense.
Another knee to the spine there, and Arias Talapsis breaks them. Naito's got to be careful not to turn though. Superlek powering up on that rear leg again.
Good job as they traded leg kicks there. It looked like Superlek got the better of it, the exchange. See, good timing on those leg kicks, right? They're both trading them, but Superlek's landing with the shin and not the foot.
With that elbow, that uppercut elbow cut him between the eyes. That was beautiful. Razor sharp, more
here
elbows
comes.
Now.
Here comes Superlek.
He said he knocked him out with an elbow. Here they come! Superlek!
Naito's got to move. He can't get trapped against the wall like that. He cannot allow Superlek to back him up because that's a dangerous spot when Superlek starts to tee off.
He wants the elbows, another downward elbow, trying to crack the top of the skull, trying to crack the clavicle,
oh,
goes to the
liver,
another elbow, and Naito tries to duke his way out.
30 seconds here for Superlek to do some work.
He's turning on a showdown
dragon.
There's
that body kick.
It's a vicious show from Superlek Katmu Kao, who has opened up Naito with the elbows here in the second.
Lots of feints coming from Superlek here as he initiates. Got his Naito back up against his wall. Naito has to circle out. He can't stay there.
Oh, elbow range is where Superlek wants to be. It's like he flipped a switch. He went from kicking range into elbow range. And elbow range has been devastating. Will Superlek go back to that elbow range he enjoyed for the second half of the previous stanza? Or will he return to kicking range and use that rear leg?
Yeah, I think he found a lot of success when he closed the distance and got inside to those elbows. I think he hurt Naito. Naito seemed to change his game after that elbow up the middle. I'd still like to see Naito move. I don't want to see him stand there. I think he's relying on his ability to counter strike.
Inside leg, high on the thigh for that femoral profunda, downward elbow, missed the target for Superlek, tries a little twist and dump.
Superlek strong inside that clinch.
Just a machine, the kicking machine. Setting the right leg.
Yeah, he's loading it up. He's like powering it up.
Oh, return the favor, how do you do?
There's aggressiveness coming from Superlek. Again, going to the body with that big right kick.
Superlek on the balls of his feet, the intensity. Look at, he throws that round kick from such a close distance. Very hard to do, but he's a master at it.
Right under the arm.
Oh, telegraph that elbow. He's going for a KO with the
elbow. Yeah, he's trying. He's trying to get Naito out of there.
Separate!
You can see why every fighter we asked, except for Naito, chose Superlek as their tournament favorite, other than themselves. He is awesome.
Oh, nice leg kick landed by Superlek there.
Naito, who has never lost against a Thai, is staring down the barrel of his first. He's got 1:05 to turn it around, and again, a step through knee from Superlek.
Listen to him grunting. Even on the outside in the clinch, Naito has that inside position, but the way that Superlek is able to clasp his hands, and he's just so strong inside there.
Grunting behind those knees. What a beast he is, Superlek. 45 seconds now on the clock. Naito's got to do something. It's been mostly defense for the Japanese warrior. Downward elbow, almost clipped him on the jaw.
Stop, stop, separate! Separate, separate!
Here he goes, marching forward again. Naito's trying to time the counter. He needs to go first, he needs to be more aggressive. He has to change things up. Ever since the middle of that second round, there he goes. But he's not following up with anything.
Oh, beautiful. Ooh, big right hand. Parrying counter there from Superlek. Catch counter.
Superlek almost looks frustrated as his ability not to find it.
Superlek can't move in the white. Look out for the right leg round kick of Superlek. There it is. And then the return kick, the left leg, the power leg out of southpaw for Pompeyac.
I know there's lots of talk about Superlek's right leg, but Pompeyac has a beautiful left leg, and he's also got really effective teeps and push kicks.
High kick round up there by Pompeyac. Teep kick to the midsection. Probing with the lead hand, fires a quick release on that round kick to Superlek. Backed against the wire here, gets off there in a hurry. Time march forward. That left leg round kick from Pompeyac, downward elbow, hoping to find the collarbone from Superlek. First elbow of the fight. Edges forward, fake the left hand, went upstairs, nice back under there from Superlek. That was straight matrix style. Knees. Traded in the clinch. Opportunity for the elbows. Breaks and fires a left round kick. Does Pompeyac.
Man, these two know each other so well. I mean, they fought eight times. This is the eighth time they fought, but they've had almost 500 matches between the two of them. So there's a lot of Muay Thai experience in the circle right now.
Pompeyac showing hand speed on that occasion. Just smiles at Superlek. Lights on the lead leg. Superlek thought about winding up the right roundhouse.
Nice little change there, though. He realized the roundhouse kick wasn't there, so he went after the inside leg, and he did it again.
Certainly both men loading up with power here in the first round. 1:10 remaining. Good punch combination. Exclamation mark with a kick under the right arm from Pompeyac.
Good hand combination thrown by Pompeyac, but good defense, too, on the retaliation that came from Superlek.
Superlek goes downstairs. Both men sporting the Prajet armbands around their biceps, part of the beautiful tradition of Muay Thai. A thousands-year-old martial art. Nicely done. Doubled up off the lead hand, and then the rear leg roundhouse kick. Step through elbow, crossing elbow from Pompeyac.
I really like that combination he threw right there. Jab to hook to left kick. Beautiful.
Olivia Cost breaks them. We've seen all the eight weapons of Muay Thai come into play in this first round. Beautiful, sticky right hand there. Just popped the jab on the chin, did Pumbaya.
He's faking with the legs, countering with the hands, faking with the hands and then countering with the legs. Pumbaya's having a sharp round. And no longer the finals of the World Grand Prix, but the winner of this fight would have a really strong case to make a fight for Rod Tang. So this is a really important matchup for both these guys.
High kicks coming off that right leg from Superlek. The kicking machine in the white. There's that jab from Pumbayak that he used well in the opening round.
Good check by Pumbayak too. He's having a lot of success being on the outside. Superlek's gonna have to change things up.
Gloves up high, turned out Woods, as is the stance for Muay Thai. Now in the clinch, center of the circle. Knee to the inside thigh from Superlek, knee to the outside thigh from Pumbayak. Olivier breaks them.
Yeah, Superlek needs to keep utilizing that right leg. He's starting to see a little bit of damage on the inside of the right leg of Pumbayak.
High check there from Pumbayak.
Pumbayak's doing a good job of checking out of these kicks.
Jab to rear leg round kick from Pumbayak. Not getting through on that occasion. It's a very basic combination. Very effective combination. Good check there from Pumbayak.
Yeah, he's doing a really good job in defense. Except that's hard to block. That super fast inside leg kick is doing some good scoring for Superlek.
Superlek hooked to an outside leg kick, totally missed the target. There is a huge purple welt on that leg of Pumbayak. Good check again from Pumbayak. Conditioned shins to be able to handle there. Power careening towards you from these kicks of Superlek. Another check there from Pumbayak. Nicely done. Round kick there from Superlek. When I talk about the check, folks, for those of you that don't watch too much Muay Thai, it's when you bring the shin up to defend or block against the opponent's kick aimed at your leg. It's called a leg check. So imagine a kicker like Superlek powering in a real leg roundhouse kick aimed at your thigh, and you are raising your shin, pointing your toes down to block it.
It's basically like taking a baseball bat to your shin, and these guys got legs of steel. So to them, not so much. To us, we're feeling it.
Back in the clinch, short-range knees from both men. Olivier Kos breaks them. 25 seconds remains. Second round of three.
You can see just how hard Superlek is kicking by the size of that welt developing on the inside of Pumbayak's.
Duck under and counter again, super fast from Superlek. We are going into the third round. We knew it would be classic Muay Thai 101 from these two. Right leg round kick to open from Superlek, then goes the inside thigh. Pumbayak closes the distance. Puts a knee guard on. No dump though from Superlek. High kick again from the kicking machine. Good, leans back like Fat Joe. Respond with a leg kick. There's an elbow, stuck it nicely.
That was a nice short elbow.
Good knee. Very tight match so far, I would say, Dragon. Maybe Pumbayak slightly ahead, but it's still anyone's game.
But also, you know, the superficial damage that's accumulating on Pumbayak's leg is going to be a sign to the judges that, you know, it's scoring and it's effective for Superlek. So it's really going to come down to the judges and how they're seeing this. Pumbayak needs to go. If he believes this match might be close, he really needs to push. His damages are one of our highest scoring categories.
Referee Olivia Cost giving the instructions in Thai. Of course, the French referee did live in Thailand for a long time. Now back in France, of course. Fake the back leg there, did Superlek. Cracks that one in. Nicely done from the kicking machine. Pumbayak. Good high defense there from Superlek. Olivia wants to see some more action. High check from Pumbayak. And off the other leg. Good defense.
Pumbayak's doing a beautiful job of shutting down that right leg. But the legs are really the only kind of hole that Superlek's able to find in the guard of Pumbayak. That one got through.
Oh, and so did that left hand from Pumbayak. Pompeo edging forward, resets. Check again, doubles the check. Nicely done from Pompeyak. And checks off the lead leg. Really saving that inside thigh by checking these leg kicks of Superlek. And that's an art in itself, Dragon.
Yeah, I mean, the reaction time these guys have is really spectacular. Nice little miss of the roundhouse to come back with the side kick.
Leans back to Superlek. Another way to defend against the leg kicks is simply to move the leg out of the way. Otherwise, to lean into it sometimes, to close the distance, not allow as much power coming in. 20 seconds to go now. Pompeyak looks for a counter, they tie up. Knees from Superlek. Looking for a dump. Referee breaks it. We are going to a decision here in Manila. Final knees from both these Thai stars. And it's gone to the judges.
Superlek Kid Muka!
Lost once and true once. Pompeyak, 8-2 in his last 10, including wins over Rui Botello, over Superlek Kemulgao and Davison Bashao. Good outside leg kick there from Superlek Kemulgao. Pompeyak in southpaw stance, Superlek in orthodox stance. Superlek known as the kicking machine. Lumpini Stadium champion in two weight divisions, Superlek, 118 and 114 pounds. WBC world champion at super featherweight, Superlek Kemulgao. Both men just seeing what each other has to offer in the opening round. Pompeyak Jomongnon in the black trunks. A Muay Thamer stylist, meaning he's a technical athlete, who uses his range exceptionally well. The equivalent in boxing would be a Floyd Mayweather. In fact, Mayweather was an inspiration for Pompeyak when he was younger. Solid start here from Superlek Kemulgao. Jab outside leg kick from Superlek. Comes over with the hands now. Roundhouse kick, then body shot from Superlek. Pompeyak ties him up in the corner. Superlek scores with a knee off to the left. Online voting polls on the One Championship Twitter feed have 30% of fans saying Superlek will win tonight. 46% are sitting on the fence undecided. Pompeyak does have the upper hand. As I said, he's beaten Superlek four times, lost once, drawn once. Good roundhouse kick to the ribs there from Pompeyak. Superlek trying to press him against the ropes here. Controlling center in, hook to a round kick there from Superlek Kemulgao. 45 seconds remains in what's been a gripping first round so far, Dragon.
Yeah, these guys know each other so well, they can almost calculate exactly what's going to happen in this match. Pompeyak's trying to use the kicks to keep Superlek away by, while Superlek is trying to close that distance and let those hands go.
25 seconds on the clock now. Superlek has gone 7-3-1 in his last 10, including 2-0 in one Super Series. Has beaten some great names. Sang Mani, Jonathan Haggerty, Christopher Shaw, Wung Tai, Saksan Okwan Wang. The list goes on for the great Superlek Kemulgao. Nice step through knee off the run at the age of 15. Good outside leg kick to open up there from Superlek. Throws the hands, goes high off the right leg, Superlek. Inside leg kick, Superlek. Hunting that femoral artery. Tip kick to the lead leg there from Pompeyak Jitwangnon. Left hook, round kick combination there from Superlek. 121 wins in 151 outings for a huge 80% finishing rate for Superlek Ketmukau. Very technical style, as you're seeing. Powerful knees for Superlek. Big soccer fan, football fan in his spare time. Supports Buriram United FC locally and Chelsea in the English Premier League. Long reach on the left hand there from Pompeyak and a gut munching knee clinched up in the corner, and referee Klaukan breaks them. We said the big winning rate of Superlek at 80%. Well, Pompeyak has that beaten. An enormous 84% winning rate. Extraordinary high winning rate in the sport of Muay Thai for Pompeyak Chikwangdon, the 24-year-old. 230 wins, 34 knockouts. Pompeyak, originally from Samut Prakam, about 30 kilometers outside of Bangkok, takes the round kick and gives one back off his left leg, being the rear leg in southpaw stance. They clinch, center of the ring, jockeying for arm positioning. Referee Klau Klan allows them to grapple for a moment. Decided there wasn't enough action and breaks them. 1:05 remaining, second round of three, Dragon.
Lots of forward pressure coming off from Superlek. You can see him trying to land those kicks, trying to open up that left side of the body of Pompeyak. Maybe get him to start covering up with the elbows to that body shot so he can start letting go of the hands up top of the head. But so far, very close matchup. These guys have so much history and they know each other so well. It's just these minor little details. Who can really get things going in these three-round Super Series matchups?
Nice little knee on the inside there from Superlek Ketmukau. Half a minute remaining, second of three. Very close contest here. Round kicks off the right leg from Superlek, off the left leg from Pompeyak. Two-time Lumpini Stadium champion at 118 and 126 pounds, Pompeyak. Two-time Rajdamun champion at 108 and 105 pounds. Beat the great Sam A. Yangadao for the Lumpini featherweight title, I remember, back in 2000. Kicked Chalam Punchai at Lumpini Stadium. There's a hit kick early from Superlek to open the third and final. Lines it up again off the right leg. Lowers the boom a little on that occasion. Thought about the jab, did Pompeyak, and again Superlek. That's why they call him the kicking machine. If he starts to set the metronome with that right leg, he will be hard to stop, Superlek. Pompeyak goes downstairs. A little higher there. Nice wall built by Superlek on the defense. Comes forward, gets into the clinch, backs up Pompeyak now. Chance for the knees, knee bar put on by Superlek, and referee Klau Klan that breaks them. Round kick from Pompeyak, the 24-year-old. Three-time Sports Writers of Thailand Athlete of the Year, 2013, 2014, 2015 for Pompeyak. That's like winning the MVP in the NBA or winning the Ballon d'Or in soccer. He won it three times in a row, Pompeyak Chikwangdon. Nice defense against the round kick there. 140 remaining. Is it still anyone's for the taking here, Dragon? How do you see it as we're into the final 90 seconds?
Man, this is pretty close. You can just see how well these guys kind of nullify each other's games. This is like their 38th round that they've competed against each other. I haven't had like sparring partners that I've had that much time against. They know each other so well. And you can see that from these shots. Every time they throw, they're deflecting it. They're just these little tiny scores that might happen. And it might be happening inside the clinch, because that's what we've seen a lot in their past matchups, is we've seen Pompeyak score successfully inside that clinch because he's got that length on Superlek.
You know what's really scary, Mitch, is that inside this audience-free arena where you can hear a pin drop, we are hearing the mighty thumping power of these Muay Thai techniques from two of the finest to ever do it, Pompeyak and Superlek. The careening of the round kicks into the legs, into the body. I mean, it sends a shiver down your spine. Can you imagine the sounds we'll be hearing, folks, later on in the night when Jodson Klai starts to wind up his round kicks, when Rod Tung starts to attack the body in 4 ounce gloves. Frightening sounds from an amazing sport brought to you by One Super Series. 15 seconds on the clock here. Looking for a combination as Superlek went high with a kick. We are going to go down to the judges yet again in this heated rivalry that's been going on for so long.
Superlek Mugao.
Superlek likes to keep that distance and throw that leg kick. And already you've seen Daniel closing a distance, so trending that boxing move, really work his game.
5 3-minute rounds in this world title fight. The belt has been vacated, so these two ranked inside the top five. The winner walks out of Bangkok with the belt.
Yeah, you know, you see Superlek right now establishing the jab and throwing more punches. He talked about that this week, that in his camp he was working on his hands a lot more this time so that he had more tools to bring to the fight.
You already seen Daniel trying to close that distance, trying to not stay in that kicking lane. Already a good overhand right. Just really focus on closing that distance, not giving Superlek an opportunity to set up that leg kick.
Ooh. Time! Stop!
Things different.
So that backward motion from Superlek that I was talking about before, just slight step backwards right there, where his kick completely misses.
Huertas firing shots to the body here. 1 minute into the first round of five.
Daniel's doing a good job in closing that distance over and over. I would love to see him close the distance and try to get off angle instead of walking right in there.
Hard right and a nice outside leg kick from Superlek. And then another right and another kick.
This is that defense where Huertas shells up that I'm talking about. See him just there, nice slip off of that, came back with a counter, it didn't land. But that's better than him shelling up because Superlek is able to tee off on him.
And that's what Daniel wants. He wants to have Superlek against the cage where he can actually tee off and get his combinations going. He's always keep on pushing him there, just trying to smother that ring. So he's not going to eat those leg kicks.
Huertas using the push kick there. Ooh. Outside, and Superlek. High with that one, a little low, however you want to look at it. Legs and got him in the groin.
I like the way Superlek's also throwing that knee. He's throwing as Daniel starts to come forward and sets up. He's going to start catching with that knee as he's coming in. He's got to be careful closing that distance that quick because that knee is coming with velocity.
That's why he's got to, when he closes that distance, he's got to get off angle to miss that knee, right? You know, Superlek is, you know, he's got his timing now, and each time he crosses that distance, he's just throwing a knee, and Daniel's running right into it.
Superlek, lightning quick, hit round one, and then a big knee.
I'll tell you what, Huertas better come up with an answer for those leg kicks as well, because Superlek is starting to chew that left leg of his up. You can see the welting on the hamstring of the left leg right now starting to form.
Stop! Stop! Separate! Separate!
Final 20 stop. Seconds, round one.
Stop. Yeah, we'll see who. Ooh. We'll see who makes the adjustments going into the second round, right? Typically, the Thais, you know, first round's kind of just reading your opponent, and then the second round, they start to make their adjustments, and they go off and roll.
So they're downloading the information, and then they make those updates.
But I think Daniel's pressure is starting to get this board pressure, and he is.
was the boxing from Puertas. I like him mixing up those body shots, getting into his range, and then those low kicks. He's got to lean on his strengths. He doesn't want to play the kicking game with Superlek.
Here he goes, in that boxing range.
Overhand right from Puertas.
Superlek kind of uses that push kick as like a moat, right? It's like a defensive force field that kind of keeps him around him just to keep his opponents away from him.
Yeah, because obviously Superlek wants to have that distance so we can get that kick-in range going on. I think he's getting a little more flustered from Daniel closing that distance and trying to get his boxing.
Body kick landed from Superlek. Going top now and then the knee.
Those two combinations right there were landing because Puertas was standing in that no man's land right in that range where Superlek can fire, and he's just kind of shelled up, not doing anything. He needs either to be in or he needs to be out.
Just need the leg right there.
1 minute into round two of this world title fight.
He's just trying to put the pressure on him, right? Sometimes you got to do that when you're going against a guy who has potentially better striking than you and a great leg kick. So you got to shut that distance down and just put him in that make it a fight, right? Because it's a five-round fight. It's a world title fight. So maybe in the fourth round, Daniel pushing the pace and closing the distance, probably going to pay dividends and be able to have his way.
He's got to make it ugly. He's got to make it dirty. He doesn't want to play that Muay Thai classic striking game. He doesn't want to give that space, make things nasty.
Absolutely.
Midway through round two. Where it's just with a jab.
Ooh, nice uppercut.
The uppercut. Dig into the body, Puertas.
I feel the pressure starting to, it's gonna pay off for him, right? Like he's sticking to the game plan. Obviously cross distance, get in Superlek space and see how he's gonna, you know, respond to that. And right here, you know, Superlek's not bouncing up taking angles. He's continuing to walk him back and keep throwing those shots, the knees and the high kick.
Hook to the body again from Puertas. He changes levels, trying to go over the top here. Final minute, second round.
Once again, crossing that distance, just trying to get into space. Right there, that's a good shot, body shot. He's just got to make sure when he gets to that angle, the Superlek covers up, he's got to get off angle. He's got to get behind that shoulder and start letting some punches go. Don't stand in front of him because that's why that knee keeps on landing right there. Every single time.
Yeah, it's very difficult to get Superlek out of position. And once you actually get him out of position, you cut that corner or something, have that angle, you have to take advantage of that.
It's a five-round fight, right? So what kind of difference do you think it's going to put in those later rounds if it does get there? Because Puertas hasn't been five rounds since 2018.
Well, it seems like he came prepared because his condition doesn't seem slowing down right now, and he's continuing to push the pace. So I feel he's used to this pressure. I feel he's committed to this game plan, the crossing distance, and staying in front.
See what I think that right hand
free.
Already.
Flyweight kickboxing world championship.
We've seen some huge upsets.
When it's kickboxing, you can't clinch. You only throw one knee when you clinch. And if you go back to the Hiro Akimoto versus One Punch Man, Hiro Akimoto did a good job of just crossing distance over and over and over and trying. They're changing.
This is the first time that we've seen Superlek moving forward. And he talked about working his hands in camp. Maybe this is the switch of direction that he needs, is actually put the pressure on Daniel Puertas, not doing that typical step back that he does. He's unloading here on the fence. Puertas is hurt.
Under siege.
He's got to move. He's got to circle. He's got to get out of there. Circle and move. And, you know, that knee almost knocked on that. Right at the chin.
With head movement, he's got to move. Get his back off the wall.
Puertas taking heavy artillery in the opening minute of the third round. Big right, big knee. Superlek teeing off.
Good head movement by Puertas. He's keeping it in him.
He's doing a good job of covering himself and not taking a lot of damage either between the slips.
He's got to get his back off that cage. He's got to get his back off the cage.
Yeah, you don't want to play rope-a-dope with Superlek.
No, especially with him, the way he's been throwing knees all fight. No, you don't want to do that.
How do you do it, DJ? How do you get out of there?
So you got to circle. You use your footwork, you know. But, you know, Daniel can, you know, use this to his advantage. You know, Superlek seems pretty spent with this, right? And once again, when the ties, they get tired, they want to clinch, right? And the ref keeps on breaking them up. So hopefully Daniel can just move off angle and be able to get something going.
Head kick from Superlek, and then another knee. And another.
Daniel doesn't quite have his feet underneath him. I think he's wobbled a little bit. He needs to move, regain his senses, not firefight right now.
He's still there. He's still there. He's trying to, he's trying to bang. He's trying to make this a real fight.
Look how wobbly he looks. Look at him.
Hey, this is all part of the game plan, all right? Don't you worry.
Uppercut from Puertas. He continues to fire strikes back.
You see, the ref keeps breaking him up because Superlek wants that close that distance for the clinch, and the ref keeps bringing him, says you cannot clinch.
You can see Querich's footwork has changed here. He's really starting to widen his stance, dig into the ground, and he's looking for that one big punch.
Here we go, see, now, ooh, that was a low blow again.
But he doesn't need that big punch. He's got to move. He's got to stick and move. Go back to what got him here so far. Keep that jab out there. Keep throwing those leg kicks.
Now it's coming out to who's in better condition. Right? Superlek just unloaded the, you know, probably 25, you know, combination. And he's still pushing forward, trying to change the narrative of the fight of him going forward instead of him backing up.
Again, Quintus back against the fence.
He was originally supposed to fight Broadtank. So he was only preparing for 3 rounds. Last minute, Anahachi drops out. He gets his shot at the gold, and you know, that changes a lot.
Yeah, I don't think preparing for 3 rounds over 5 rounds is that much of a difference. It's just having the intelligence to run a different pace.
Yeah, so let's see if this pressure is going to pay dividends. He's been going forward the whole fight, besides the last round, where Superlek was really pushing forward to try to change the narrative of the fight. Gotta close that distance and stop eating those leg kicks. Close that distance, get on him, put the pressure on him.
This is that range that I was talking about before, where Quintus is standing right there in the mid range, where Superlek is just throwing those kicks. Coming in, get in, tight on the inside, throw the combinations, and get back out.
Yep, absolutely.
Nice uppercut.
Shots from Quintus, head kick from Superlek.
There's that nice box from Daniel. Now here is corner scene. Keep crossing distance. When you get to that distance, let your box and go. Light him up. And that's where Daniel wants to be, right there. Put Superlek trying to decide what is he going to do. Where he wants to clinch. He wants that clinch. Right? He wants that clinch to stop Daniel's pressure. And right there. This is where Daniel wants to be, right there. He's got to get there, get off angle, let five punches go, and then.
Stop!
This is the head movement you're talking about. He slipped off the line with that punch there, came back to the body with the shovel hook.
Stop!
He was getting a lot of kicks on that arm. I asked him about that. I was like, how are you going to deal with those kicks? He's like, dude, now I got arms of steel. I'm going to take it. Stop! Right back with the answer. And he's staying true to his word.
Yep. And see, like I said before, this is what you see. You saw it when One Punch fought Hiroaki Goto. He always kept closing a distance in the kickboxing match. He wants to hold because he's not used to this pressure and conditioning.
America,
right?
In early May.
Hey, it feels good. It feels good to be here and to try to share some of my knowledge, surface side, with you gentlemen. And I think Daniel's got to keep keeping that pressure there, because he can't, Superlek cannot break that habit of this right here, of closing the distance. He wants to hold.
Elias may take, the referee might take a point away. This keeps happening with this clinch. You know, you're not allowed to clinch under kickboxing rules.
I think Daniel's doing a good job of forcing him to clinch, because he's not, right here, once again, he doesn't like that pressure. Right? Daniel is just trying to force the action and get there to where he's comfortable. Where Superlek needs that distance, he wants to be able to throw, right? So just keep crossing that distance and forcing the clinch. Maybe the ref can take a point.
What's the difference between clinching and like tying up like you do in boxing, right? I mean, he's not actually clinching, looking for the clinch from a
Muay Thai standpoint.
Exactly, yeah. But you're not supposed to use the clinch defensively either, by the rule set here in kickboxing and World Championship.
Yeah, and you've seen, you know, Superlek, he's always initiating that clinch. He's always initiating the grab. And I think Superlek's using it in order to stop Daniel's, you know, arsenal. Because when he gets in this range, I believe Daniel is winning the fight.
I like that. So who do you have ahead on the scorecards after four?
You know what? I'm gonna go ahead and go with even. 2-2. 2-2.
He mitched out. That was a Chilson.
So the fifth and perhaps deciding round in this world title fight.
Well, it's hard because you don't know what's being more damaging. You know, I love how Daniel's really causing that pressure. And once again, he keeps on. Grab me, please.
Here he comes again. Quintus on the offensive. Head kick go from Superlek on the way out. Another one from Superlek.
This right here is Daniel Quintus going to take it. He needs to take advantage of it.
Yep, once again, boom, there's a clinch. Every single time. And Daniel's got to close that distance. He can't stay in that kicking range where Superlek can just keep throwing those high kicks.
Yeah. Superlek has responded since being issued the yellow card.
Quintus had a nice lean back right there, made Superlek miss. That's what he should be doing this entire match.
2 minutes to go in this world title fight.
Yeah, it's very hard to see who's scoring and who's up and who's down.
This is a good little kicking defense from Puertas with his lean backs.
See right there? If I was Superlek, I would have let go and did a five-piece combination, not use that clinch in order to stop the fight. But see, he's... Uh-oh. Now he's getting down with the clinch.
Puertas digging in with that left hook. Defensive again. For the body and then the low kick. Fires a right hook and a left as Puertas. And there's the big right to the face of Superlek.
Keep closing that distance right there. He's got to go. See, now that Superlek is ducking his head, each time he gets to that distance, he's got to get off angle. I've been seeing it all night. Get off angle. I'm going to cross that distance.
Head kick from Superlek and then to the body.
See, but Daniel's now found an answer for. He might take a kick, but he's throwing the little leg kicks. There's always an answer for Puertas, and I like that this round. And he's got the yellow card.
There we go, right there. Push him off. You got to get him offline and hit him. Hit him with the right hand. Once he clinches, well, he's not clinching anymore. He's just ducking his head in there once he gets that distance.
You know, Mitch, you mentioned the yellow card, and that's going to affect the score of this round, I'm sure, but keep in mind that this is a 10-point must system fight. This isn't judged in its entirety, so it's only going to help him out in this round, so to speak. This is all going to depend on how the judges have the earlier rounds of this match score.
Pretend judge over there had it 2-2, Mr. DJ. So that could be it.
I'm professional, okay? I you know, as I'm watching it, like I said, I don't know how the judge is going to score it when Superlek throws a high kick and Daniel blocks it with his glove. Like, how is that score? Right? I mean, it looks bad, but you know, he is blocking it. Now here's Superlek going forward.
But normally we can see a little bit of reddening on the back of Daniel's shoulder, but not too much. So that's not really going to count in one of our highest scoring categories, which is damage, Rich. So how are they scoring these when he's taking them all in the arm?
But see, go ahead, sorry. But now you're seeing Superlek in the last 10 seconds.
Superlek!
Monster, who's fast with the combinations like Fadi Khalid, we're about to find out. Superlek without the extended clinch, without the elbows here, shouldn't bother him though. Left hook early there from Fadi Khalid, good roundhouse kick from Khalid. Superlek wants to get those kicks going early, he does so off the back leg, that power leg of Superlek Kepmukau. Multiple time world champion. One of over 150 martial arts world champions on the one roster is Superlek Kepmukau. Fadi Khalid gloves high, went for a jumping knee. Superlek saw it coming, cracks away to that lead thigh. Good outside leg kick there from Fadi Khalid. At the moment, Khalid answering Superlek inside the opening 45 or 50 seconds here. On the outside, Fadi Khalid. A high kick there from Khalid. Superlek tries to press him against the ropes. Outside leg kick from Superlek. Double jab. Look for the leg kick again from the kicking machine. Hands are low. Trying to bait Fadi Khalid. Body shot. Looking for the liver there off the lead hand. Fadi Khalid. Spinning back fist from Khalid. Oh, Khalid rattles it beautifully. Done with the left hook. Smack bang on the kisser. Fadi Khalid's opened up like a house on fire. Like I told you, the punching combinations of Fadi Khalid. He is outscoring the kicking of the kicking machine so far. Khalid drifts back to center ring. Long extension on the lead hand from Khalid. Outside leg kick from Superlek. But Khalid answers. Superlek has the big experience advantage. 125 wins to Khalid's 40. But you wouldn't know it looking at this one right now. Superlek, who's gone 8-1-1 in his last 10, comes in off a hat-trick of wins. The Lumpini Stadium world champion in two weight divisions. And Khalid almost threw that illegal elbow, the referee cautioning for that right crossing elbow. This is a blistering start from Fadi Khalid. The Tunisian, the 25-year-old, these days based out of Pattaya, is turning it up in the first round. Counters off the round kick. jumping knee attempt there from Funny Carl, and high kick from Superlek. Looping left hand from Superlek, and Carl with the leg kick. Funny Carl looking to set the metronome here, set the rhythm. Upset the rhythm of Superlek. If you upset the Thai's rhythm, that's where you can really catch them cold. Outside leg kick from Funny Khalid. Machine Superlek Kapukau. Funny Khalid opened up like a house on fire. You'll see the intensity build on the kicking repertoire now of the kicking machine. But he's got to watch that left kick from Funny Khalid. That seems to be the prime weapon that's getting through for Khalid time and time again. And if Fadi can pivot on the foot, turn the knuckles in, and catch Superlek on the jaw, he may just drop the Thai superstar. You see Fadi Khalid hunting for that left hand repeatedly. What he can't do, though, Fadi, is telegraph that lead hook. You see now Superlek is expecting that lead hook. He's watching specifically for that technique. Outside leg kick from Fadi Khalid. Superlek tucking the chin. Got to protect that jawline against the lead hand of Fadi Khalid. They clinch a knee from Fadi. Referee Calvin breaks them. Jumping knee from Superlek. The nephew, of course, of the great Singdam Kapmukau. An all-time great, Singdam Kapmukau. What pedigree here for Superlek Kapmukau. Good double forearms guard against the round kick, and Khalid goes downstairs. The counter game of Khalid tonight has been on point so far. He clinches up Superlek, ties him up, referee Kaufling breaks them. Khalid coming off that great win over Huang Ding back on August 14. Spinning back fist there, jumping knee! Khalid gets airborne. Some better signs here from Superlek Kapmukau in the second round. Unofficially, I will say I did have Funny Khalid winning the first round, 10-9. Right hand lead there from Superlek. Khalid again clips him with that left hand. He's had more hooks than a tackle box, has Funny Khalid. If anything is going to drop Superlek Dragon, it's going to be the left hook of Funny Khalid.
Yeah, he's throwing it with pinpoint accuracy, too. He waits for Superlek to throw that right kick, and as soon as he does, he steps inside, so you can see that he's really trying to close that distance and land that left hook over and over again. It's that left hook of Khalid against the right leg of Superlek.
This may be kickboxing rules. This may be against a Thai star, but Funny Khalid knows all about competing against the Thais. He moved to Thailand in 2009. He trains alongside the world champion Aliverdi Ramazan of the great Medi Satut out there at Venom Training Camp in Pattaya. And he is putting in a superb performance against Superlek Kapmukau. Double forearms guard against that round kick again. Superlek trying to break down those arms. One round apiece after two. Tip kick to open up. Good rib kick there from Superlek. Evasion from the kicking machine. Again, winding up. You see the right leg. What he's trying to do here is not only go to the ribs of Khalid, but more so try to break down the left forearm of Fadi Khalid. Superlek knows the left hook of Fadi is the Tunisian's prime weapon. He's going to crack away at that forearm. Crack away at that humerus bone over and over again and try and take out that lead hook. Try and get Fadi Khalid to drop the lead hand and then try and loop the shoot around the back of the neck for a head kick knockout. Khalid's got him on the outside. Overhand right from Fadi. There's the left hand. Superlek with a right hand lead. He's enjoyed using the right hand lead all night, Superlek. Khalid tried for an uppercut on the inside. Chance for the knees. Referee Klauklund breaks them. Under 2 minutes remaining, third and final round. Spinning back fist from Fadi Khalid, trying to channel his inner Manson Gibson. Comes forward again to Fadi. On the front foot as he was against Wang Ding last time out. What a quick turnaround for both of these men. Both of them competed successfully in our One A New Breed series in August. And here they are now
stepping up to the plate again. Left hook to an inside thigh kick there from Fadi Khalid. That's the bread and butter combination for Fadi Khalid. He's used it so much throughout his career in kickboxing and in Muay Thai. Like Superlek, he is more used to competing under Muay Thai rules. But he is putting on a superb show against a multi-time world champion. WBC Super Featherweight World Champion, Lumpini Stadium World Champion in two weight divisions, Superlek Kiatmukau. One of so many world champions signed to one Super Series. Misses with the front kick. Misses with the knee, as Fadi Khalid. Khalid, an intercontinental champion, hoping to break into the one Super Series rankings and get a title shot somewhere down the line. Superlek ties him up. 20 seconds remains. This would be considered an upset, folks, if Fadi Khalid beats Superlek Kiatmukau. If he beats a three-time world champion. We are going to go down to the judges in Bangkok. Jumping knee from
red corner, Superlek Kiatmukau.
Doesn't go on for too long. It's all action here. Right hand from Botello was a nice one as Superlek was coming in. Flying knee. Huge noise from the crowd behind me here in Bangkok. Just grabbed that foot, hit from a colossal right hand. Botello ducked underneath it.
See how well Superlek is using the fence. He's able to back Botello up because Botello's not circling out. He can't allow Superlek to come in like this.
All he can there. Superlek unleashing a great effort and straight back into it as Olivier Costa brings them together. Right hand, nice short punch from Superlek.
Then he's parrying down the lead hand. Botello with his lead hand, he's swapping down the hand. That's what's going to circle around and land that big right hand.
This is so intense from Superlek. You get the feeling that Botello is just being a little bit reactionary, just looking at what's going to happen and see if he can counter. That is leading the action. Just has a little brush of his right eye there to see if he's been marked.
Nice right hand landed by Botello. That's what he needs more of. He's closed that distance and throw those hands.
Superlek comes back with his own. These two are just not holding back. 35 seconds left in this opening round. It's been wonderful action, looking for the spinning back elbow there, Botello. Charging in with the kick to the head. Back in the center of the circle now, 24 seconds left. The right hand from Superlek comes back, but his leg is held, and they go down to the mat, and Superlek landed quite heavily. Botello landed on top of him. So a little bit of a warning there from Olivier Costa. 10 seconds left in this opening round. It's been all action. Super stuff.
Good job by Botello to get that leg up and check that right kick. Big gloves. Now they have to adjust their style of defense to complement the little gloves.
as well, punishing, pushing Botello back. He throws is being cheered by the home fans here. Botello battling not only his opponent, but the entire Impact Arena, seemingly. Botello just looking over his shoulder, trying to take a little bit of advice from his corner man. Yes, they know everything about this sport. The fans here at the Impact Arena. Muay Thai is their bread and butter, and they are really enjoying this. Hope you can hear their cheers at home every time something is thrown. And it's good work from Superlek, isn't it? Knees to the side of the body, answered by Botello.
Botello's showing some good eyes. He's been able to evade a lot of the big kicks thrown by Superlek, and then Superlek actually starts kicking at the hip. So instead of Botello moving out of the way, those hips don't move, and he starts attacking the leg of Botello.
As these two athletes. 121 left of the second round. The left hand, it was a chopping left hand.
And then elbow came answering right back from Superlek. And Superlek narrowly missed that left hand, but then just stepped in with a beautiful timed elbow.
1 minute left of the second round. The action continues to be relentless. Left, right from Botello. Not cleanly landed though. Superlek ushers him in. Says, come on, let's have a battle here in the center of the circle.
Botello can't get sucked into that game. He's got to keep moving.
Botello gets pushed back to the circle wall there with a super kick to the center of the body.
Superlek's trying to egg him on, and Botello's answering, but he's got to move. He cannot just play this game with Superlek.
30 seconds left of the second round. Everything into that kick, but it was parried by Botello. He's enjoying this, isn't he? The tie. Big right hand just pushes the jaw. Just gets a little bit untidy. Dying moments of the second round. A Muay Thai contest for us all to enjoy here. Bangkok, Thailand. The fans enjoying the final moments as Superlek goes to war again with that right leg. Ragdolls his man to the ground. There's a little bit of tension between these two. Shorts. His opponent, Superlek in the right, and again he goes up high with the leg and then comes downstairs to the ribcage. And again he's beckoning Botello in, just teasing him, annoying him. What a wonderful kick that went to the jaw, follows it up with another one, and Botello might be in a bit of trouble here. The elbow to the head as well. Superlek's leg gets held. The action in the first 30 seconds of this round has been intense. Kick to the waist there from Superlek. And that damaging sort of teak kick above the knee that can hyperextend it. Also clearly in his arsenal. Has a little shake of the head there, Superlek. Not quite going the way he wants it to. He's got just over 2 minutes to give this crowd a spectacular finish.
Good balance by Superlek. As Botello had his leg elevated, tried to sweep out, but he was the one that ended up down. Superb balance shown by Superlek.
Good work to the body from the Portuguese. Couple of left hands. Nice and low to the ribcage, earning the respect of Superlek, who's teased him at times. Power of that kick, and now Botello gives him a little smile and a nod and extends the hand of friendship, the sportsmanship that we see so often in the World Championship circle. Good right hand from Superlek, landed flush on the jaw. 120 left of this third and final round.
Those kicks are landing to the hip of Botello because he's got good eyes. He's moving out of the way of the head kick. So Superlek's attacking that right left side of the body and the hip of Botello.
And Botello comes in with his punches and puts everything into it. And if he misses, which he occasionally does, he is very vulnerable to a sharp counter from the top. Olivia Cost really has had a workout in this one. Once again, sportsmanship on show. 45 seconds left. Elbow coming in from Superlek, and it landed. A bit of a clinch there on the circle wall. The way Superlek comes in, gains those distance with those elbows, and they come from a lot of different angles, Steve. Just wanted to remark upon the sportsmanship again there, Mitch. It's been fiercely contested, this one, but in the spirit that we so commonly see in one championship. And once again, Superlek just has a little paw at that eye to see if there's been any damage done. It's clearly bothering him a little bit. So Patello knows he's done some damage. Is it enough?
Tie in four rounds, gloves. It doesn't get any better than this. Roundhouse kicks early from Superlek. He's going straight after Malchitra. High right roundhouse kick from Superlek. Ketmugan. Jumping roundhouse kick from the tie. A three-time world champion. House on fire in the opening 30 seconds.
Watch that right side. He's hammering the legs, hammering the body, and he's going to start breaking down the body and go up top.
Chetra has reach in the arms, he's got to use it, he's got to keep Superlek at bay. Inside thigh kick there from the quick champion. Superlek goes downstairs, control and center ring. Tracks away with the right leg again. Starts under nicely done, now Chetra applies a clinch. Superlek gets a knee off to the ribs, and referee Onari breaks them. What a start here from the three-time world champion, Superlek. Outside of the kick again. Angelo now lifts them high on the balls of his feet. Cracks away with that roundhouse kick, step through knee there from Superlek. He is pulling out all the weapons, all the eight weapons of Muay Thai here in the first round.
Go! You can see Lau Tetra's having a hard time with the speed. I don't think he's used to starting this fast. Superlek is not following the Muay Thai rule set. He is going right after him in the first round.
Because Mitch, you aren't here. This is one super series. It's only three rounds. You can't take a filling out process in the first and second. It's all about action. It's all about knockout. And that's what Superlek's looking for here in the opening stanza.
He is. And that's what, and you can see that Lau Tetra is having a hard time. He can't get into the clinch. He can't utilize those elbows. There it is. Now he's trying to fire the elbows.
A two-time Kumkumai world champion in the white trunks. Finding the get-go very hard in the opening round here against a three-time world Muay Thai champion. Right hand down the tube there from Superlek, then goes to the break basket. Planting right hand from Superlek. Now Chetra ties him up, chunk for the knees, chunk for the elbow. Knee there from Lau Chetra, downward elbow, hoping for the collarbone. Superlek just all over it. Advances up to his screen as the three-time world champion to see how much time's left in the round.
Interesting clinch game from Superlek. He's utilizing the outside over underhooks to get this because he's not trying to swim in and get inside control. He's very comfortable staying on the outside and using the defensive strategy so that he can create openings and throw elbows in the knees of his own.
Go!
A tremendous start from Superlek Ketmugan. 2012 Sports Authority of Thailand, world champion martial artists, European Championship. And you see that in here, Superlek with a kicking arsenal. More kick than a porous line for Superlek here in the second round. And here come the hands.
Wow, it was like the first round, he actually was going kind of slow. Because that was 10 unanswered kicks from Lau Tetra by Superlek.
Make that 11. And there's 12, and there's 13.
right leg is devastating. Here comes the power from Superlek Kipmuka. Front kick to the midsection. Overhand elbow from Lau Chetra. Trying to get on the inside. And now Superlek ties him up against the ropes. A little slap and a tingle there from Atsushi Onari. And he breaks it. Look at the defense on the way in from Superlek. Wraps him over the forearms. That one goes down to the waist. That one goes down to the legs. It is all the right leg of Superlek here in the second round. Goes to the body, belly button through the back. Short elbow on the inside there from Lau Chetra.
Chetra needs more of that straight left hand or that right hand. He needs to put that jab out there. Every time Superlek throws a kick, he's got to answer it. He's got to come back.
High kicks again from Superlek, breaking down the forearms of Lau Chetra. Digs the toes into the midsection. Lau needs to use that reach. High kick there from the Cambodian. The three-time Muay Thai champion in the red and blue, Superlek Kipmulgao, doing a number here in the second. Snakes the arms around the back of the neck, drills it into the midsection. Lau, no chance to get off the elbows. Referee, oh no, separates them. It is all out action in one super series. This is Muay Thai with four out gloves. This is the most electrifying martial arts stand-up in the world in four out gloves. And it's awesome to see, Mitch.
It is. And then what is awesome is that right kick from Superlek. He's thrown more right kicks than he has punches in this second round. Look at it. He just keeps hammering the body, the legs, the head of Lau Chetra.
That one to the humerus, but there was nothing funny about it. They punch up in the corner. He got put on by Superlek. Tango against the ropes and referee. Oh, now he breaks them. Final seconds of what has been a cracking second stanza for the three-time Muay Thai world champion, Superlek. And again with the right. Body shot there. Behind the balls of his feet, Superlek. Dancing, grooving. Oozing confidence from every pore. And there's going to be a lot of work for now, checking traffic. And all the traffic has come via that right leg, the right shin of Superlek Kipmulgao.
Man, the whole left side of Lau Chetra's body is a completely different shade than the right side of his body.
It looks like it's been sunburned. It's reddened the entire carcass and the legs of Lau Chetra. And Superlek sets the right leg again. Lau Chetra backs him up, tries for a flying knee to no avail. Chucks the elbows off the right here.
Stop.
And referee, oh, now he breaks it.
We're seeing incredible offensive strategy from Superlek, but we're seeing defense as well. We're seeing a very pinpoint, accurate defensive strategy from Superlek. And that's what's made Lau Chetra so frustrated with. He's not able to do anything. We just saw it as he was trying to jump in for that knee. Just a little subtle adjustment from Superlek, and he was able to stop the jump. It's very impressive.
You are seeing the skill, the poise, the speed, and the scintillating power that has made Superlek Kipmulgao a three-time world Muay Thai champion. Racks away again with the right roundhouse kick. That shin has done incredible damage. Knee guard put on here by Superlek. And referee Onari separates both these warriors, two tremendous athletes, two world champions. Southpaw stance on the Cambodian. His inside leg is a shade of purple, a kaleidoscope for colors. The crowd are counting the kicks from Superlek. And they spill to the canvas. Nice dump there from Superlek Kipmulgao. Slow to pick himself up. Here's Lau Chetra, 1:05 remaining. Three judges ringside scoring on a 10-point must system. And you figure they must have given the first round 10-9, the second round 10-9 to Superlek, the three-time world Muay Thai champion. Superlek winds up the roundhouse kick again, gets out the way of the elbow. A nice low check there from Superlek. Lines up the right again, here it comes, there it goes to the body, doubles up on it. Overhand elbow from Lau Chetra, downward elbow! Taking the crest of the collarbone of Kipmulgao.
Lao Tezra said he wanted to do. He wanted to close that distance and start dropping those elbows. He's able to do it last 30 seconds of the match.
There's a very special lady we're going to show you here in a moment who is screaming amongst our super fans here ringside. I'll tell you who she is in a few seconds' time, but she is going bananas for someone in the ring right now. Jumping knee from Lao Tezra, hoping for a Hail Mary shot, hoping for one